Hey, what's going on, everybody? Thanks for joining us for this week's ArcAge Friday livestream. My name is Merv, I go by Krollin, and I'm a producer for ArcAge. Alongside me today, I have Sophie. She goes by Sok, or Zoke, and she is a localization tester. On the couch is Amanda. She goes by Amory. She's also an ArcAge producer, and alongside her, of course, is Kirby. He looks a little bit sleepy right now, but he's there. And over Skype, Serafina. She goes by Celestrada. She's our senior community manager. Wow, it's good to see everybody. What's going on? How are you guys doing?
I'm doing good over here. I see everyone's doing pretty good over in chat, too. I see a lot of alohas, hellos. Celestrada, will there be a beginning of stream giveaway? I don't know. That's not always my jam.
You want to do it?
You want to do one?
Okay. That's not the order we had things going on here, but we're going to do it. So go ahead and I'll give you guys a moment to X up for whatever it is I'm going to give away. I don't even know. So
you know what? As they X up, we can actually just sit here and go down some of the stuff at the beginning, get it all out, and then we can jump right into the White Arden Ghost Wedding Festival, which is coming up next week.
Okay, we're on our internal server today. We can cut over to game now. And Sophie will be talking us through that system later. I think we have a couple things to talk about first.
We do have a few brief notes for everyone. So really importantly, the big news, the Joyful Home Builder Society is back, for those of you who didn't see it. Or it looks like Rose Avenel has another good set of challenges for everyone, and that's spring garden homes. You want something that's springy and gardeny and beautiful and cleansing to the palate. That's what she tells me, at least. That will be ending on April 27th, so make sure to get in your submissions. There is a bonus just for submitting screenshots of the competition, and more information is available in the forums in the announcement section. So don't miss out. If you have a home, just go in, take a screenshot of it, make it look a little bit pretty, and you can get some stuff just for even participating in the society's contest. Beyond just that, we hope you're all enjoying the bountiful amount of labor and Lunarite coming from the Golden Tree event. That it is only going to last until April 25th and April 26th in some other areas. So make sure you're jumping on that, planting your trees every day, getting out those fruits, and getting as many rewards as possible. And I think some of you are on track for getting that 14, that was the 14 petal box. So good on you guys. Otherwise, enjoy the golden apples and the other boxes available in the game. I think that's enough time to actually go draw a winner, and we can move on then with the White Arden Ghost Festival.
Okay.
That's all I got.
Normally, I have a list of things that I intend to give away. But when a surprise like this happens, you know, you just kind of have to go with it. So we're going to give away whatever this is. it's going to make a lot of noise if I try to do that, I think. So we'll just leave it in for now. But this is called the whatever this is. And obviously it's a Yada head. It's on a stick.
It's like a cake pop.
I believe there's a lot of different things you could do with this. I don't know what the original intent is. It might provide healing power. It might provide magic damage. I really don't know. But this is what I'm giving away, so X up for it, and we'll roll in a moment.
You use it to put it on like your massage.
It's like a back massage.
Yeah,
Yada on a stick. Very Yada bopper. Okay, thanks,
Yada bopper.
Kirby thinks it's a toy. He thinks it's for chewing on.
Whatever you tend to do with it.
I mean, it can kind of like
peek up over the table.
Yeah.
That's cute.
I don't think we've given away one of these on the stream before, so yeah.
Have we not? I could swore we did.
Maybe. I think we did at an event once, at PAX or something.
But I remember showing them up to everyone going, ooh.
Okay, we're going to roll. All right, good luck, everybody. This is for whatever this is.
Yada pop.
Reyna with a W. Congratulations,
yay.
Reyna, on whatever this is.
She's drunk on coffee.
Barbecue Yada head? No!
Reyna.
I mean, Chad has some really good suggestions on what it might be, but congratulations. All right, so let's move on. Let's move into Ghost Wedding.
Okay.
White Arden Ghost Wedding.
Okay.
Okay, so the event this time takes place in White Arden. you'll be able to get the portals to the venue from all the usual places that you're used to in Ostera, Marianopol, and whatnot. It'll take you straight to Ardenia, and of course, the zone will be in peace for the festival, so you can't hit each other. When you arrive, the first NPC will send you over into this area, and basically, so the ghost wedding, so in White Arden, there's like a very thin layer between the living and the dead, and there's a lot of ghost encounters over there. The ghost couple is a very peaceful and nice couple that keeps coming back every year to renew their vows, and the Arden guards are really fans of that cute couple and decided to devote this event to them and kind of help them organize it. So you will help the Arden Guard organize the wedding, basically. There's a couple of different quests. Well, you have to go and collect hereafter roses to make a bouquet for the bride. There's a quest where you have to go and make a wedding ring for the ghost bride. As you can see, the roses are right here, so that's easy enough. You collect, you turn it in, you are done with it. Another quest that this NPC gives to you is to donate to the Arden Guards for helping organize that. The donation itself is only, 10 labor. So you don't actually give them anything other than 10 labor. You use the item to turn it into an envelope that you can then drop into the donation box that's right here, and that will be that.
That's a cool looking donation box.
I know, right? It's like the otherworldly storage chest, only see-through.
Yeah, cool.
You turn in your donation thing, and that quest will actually give you a token. By the way, this is all outdated text right now on this build, so it'll be named slightly different. But this token that you're getting, you can then take over to the couple. You can already see the rewards here. You can take it over to the ghost couple. There's a see-through altar-looking thing that you can interact with to turn in the token and bless the couple. And as a reward for doing that, they'll give you a temporary version of this amazing costume that I'm wearing right now.
So you could RP your own ghost wedding.
Yes, you can RP your own ghost wedding. It's a temporary costume, as you can see, but at least during the event, you'll be able to use that. You'll also get a soul mare, a temporary version, so you can just be super awesome.
Double down on the ghost.
So let's do one thing real quick. I think, you know, we don't often see this sort of decor in Arcage, so let's get maybe an above shot and kind of a good pan around that layout, because it's really cool looking.
Into the tree.
And that's an
Asian driver, sorry.
And as we're doing it, let's remind everyone that these items will last until the end of the event, but after that, they're going to expire out from your inventory. So make sure to use them after you get them during the event.
Right, and it's just cosmetic items to be cool during the wedding or dressed appropriately for the wedding if you're attending. So the whole area is basically this that's set up for it.
A really good question from Expendable Zero, which is there any way to make those items permanent during this festival?
There is not. I have not seen a way to make these permanent.
And these items were used in Arcage prior to this. I saw someone in chat already mention, mentions that she has both of them. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, in my opinion, you're ready to attend right now if you have them both already. But for those of you who don't, you can get them temporarily just for the duration of the event.
In fact, for the temporary items for this event, it's going to be those costumes and items and the Wraith Wisp tokens. The coins will actually stay permanent at the end of the event. I know that there was some concern because an initial version of the note said that the coins would expire. They do not. They will last for the entire event. And afterwards, and you'll be able to retrieve your rewards from the vendor as normal.
So I see you're at the festival gift exchanger. What are the rewards?
Yes. I also want to address really quick before we get to the rewards, the timed quest. I know there were questions about it for the Yada Lantern Festival. So, of course, as the past events, there's going to be a timed quest, which usually you'll have your thing spawn around the same times, which in Pacific is usually around 11 in the morning, 5 p.m. at reset, and then either 8 or 10 p.m. So again, this time around, you'll be able to find those NPC here. They're not disappearing, so you can go pick up the quest at any time you like. However, the NPC that you have to interact with, the timed event one, this part in this case, will only show up right at the beginning of the hours that are listed. I'm not going to show this because it's the old text. I don't want to confuse anyone. So the bard appears right on the hour when you go there, and he stays there, but only until the player's interacted with him a certain amount of time. So I think that's where the confusion is for. Was about. He's not going to stay there for a full hour. People go there and play these hereafter loots to drive him away. Once enough players have done that, the bard will actually go away, and you have an item that spawns that you have to interact with to complete the quest. Now, that item also does not stay the full hour. It stays for a couple of minutes and then goes away, very much like the Yada Lantern Festival. So if you want to make if you want to complete this quest, please make sure that you show up on time when the thing begins. Participate and turn it in, because otherwise, I've seen, like, for the Gwinnett Festival, like, within 10 minutes, this whole thing was completed and gone, and people were upset that they weren't able to do the quest. You really have to show up on time if you want to do that.
Okay, so what are you doing here? You're playing the instruments to drive him away?
Yeah, so basically, so everybody's trying to set up this nice wedding, including these musicians, right? And this bard is just like a completely shitty singer, and he comes back and sings terrible songs that nobody wants to listen to.
Okay.
So you go back and play those hereafter lutes to kind of like cover his terrible singing and drive him away. And then when he goes away, you'll have a giant Morpheus plushie spawn.
I was thinking, like, maybe drunk uncle or something.
Drunkle. Exactly. Drunkle.
Drunkle.
Right. Drunkle, for sure.
Yeah. But basically, yeah, he's a shitty singer. Drive him away. Interact with the giant plushie that spawns after. Make sure you show up on time for that quest. Just because he's not going to stick around forever. He's going to appear as soon as the quest has been completed.
So you'd say he's trolling the ghost wedding?
Yes. Yeah. Yes. Well, in his mind, I'm sure he thinks he's a fantastic singer. So, you know.
There you have it.
Yep.
Okay, rewards.
So on the gift exchange, you will see this top part, which is the wedding ring. This is that quest that I mentioned earlier. You can craft the wedding ring for that quest right here, and it only takes hereafter stones that you can buy at any general merchant. So that's that part. So that's not an actual reward. This is a quest item that you craft for that event.
If things don't work out, can you sell your wedding ring at like a Daru secondhand merchant?
You can sell like 50% of what you paid for.
So you can complete the quest by either crafting and then turning it in, or you can just make a bunch of keep them on you if you don't want to go back and craft it every time. If you have any left over, you can salvage them with an even stone, and that will give you back your 3 hereafter stones that you use for that.
Okay.
So that's not a reward. Those are the rewards listed down here. There's a couple of really cool things, stuff people have been waiting on, like the Sacred Echo, which is like a ghost-themed loot. Of course, we have a decoration version of that. Then there's the ghost piano people have been waiting on.
Ghost piano.
A one-handed weapon that looks like a flower bouquet.
And so hold on, let's mouse over that one again.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, is this an image item?
You can image it if you like to, yes. And then if you want to reenact your own wedding, I guess you already have the dress. You can get this ticket and go to Sand Deep and hold the party there. A ghost-themed table, and I'm totally going to show you guys all those items, the decoration items after this. And then lastly, a item if you don't want any of the decoration items or have any tokens left over. You can get your temporary buffs from this item as well.
Expendable Zero from chat asks, is the ghost piano out of tune?
Should be. It should be creepy, like, kind
Maybe.
Of...
Maybe. Like,
it's a great
rad.
Idea is
I
what
know.
It is. I don't think it is, but that would be fantastic.
Creepy minor key. And someone else also asked, when does this begin? This is going to begin on technically April 25th. In America, April 26th in Europe. And the reason is that it's going to require a server downtime and restart. So you're going to see next week on Tuesday that we're going to be restarting the servers. And that's to make sure the festival starts and flips over appropriately into festival mode.
G's Girl asked, how do you get there?
There's going to be world gates at all your major cities like Ostera, Marianopol, Growl Gate, also in Diamond Shores, I believe, usually. You will be able to see those world gates that will take you straight there.
Cool. All right, so where are we going now?
I'm going to show you the items from the wedding now. So there's the piano, the table, and the decorative flute that I wanted to show you guys.
Last time this happened, I got trolled, so I'm a little worried. Not going to lie. I'm a little hesitant. Oh, wow. Lo and behold, looks like it's Candyland.
These are always the best.
So, right here we have the hereafter table, the cake table that you can get.
I see it.
No.
What is that? What is that is in the... What the hell is that?
It's our friend Clowny.
So creeper.
No,
I don't Clowny. Like
I am not a fan of that.
I like him.
Chat's all like, oh, so cute. They're like, it hasn't caught up yet to where they're seeing the glory.
Okay.
It's caught up a dove. There it is. There, it's caught up now.
Okay.
There we go, okay.
So this is the table. You light in a fire and the wine glasses fill.
So nice.
The cake there. You can turn it back out to give it back its ghostly appearance.
That piano is sick.
This is the lute, which you can barely see because it's see-through. But this is a decorative lute. And then, of course, the piano, which you can play music on.
That's so cool.
I don't know if game sound is on, but this is what it sounds like if it's on. If it's not, this is what it looks like if you play it.
It's on now.
Looks so good.
Sweet. So it's not really out of tune. I wish it was now.
You're playing wedding music.
Yes. Appropriate, right? Gonna marry Clowny.
Clowny looks like he belongs on a watch list. You know, you don't understand how many chats.
Also, by the way, the instrument can also be skinned, which I did here just to show. So if you don't like the stats that the instrument itself gives you, you can just make it, turn it into a image item and put it on whatever instrument you're using. And that looks really cool, too. There you go. It's like hard to see because it's easier.
That's rad, yeah. I bet if your costume wasn't also transparent, too.
Like, it's really, really cool. Mm. Oh, and this is the weapon. There you go. Your bashing bouquet. Yeah, and those are the rewards for the Ghostwing. I don't think I forgot anything.
So can you regrade that bashing bouquet?
I have not tried. I'm sure you could, though.
Should
Let's
say.
Let's see. Blah, blah, blah. Oh, no. Derp.
Mythic bouquet.
Yeah, I don't know.
It looks like no. It normally says regrade available.
It would.
Yeah.
Okay. Just had to see if there would be, you know, in the Tuna Club's legacy.
Mythic flowers.
Mythic flowers.
Yeah.
Okay, so what is this house?
What are these houses?
There's a lot going on.
This is the Candy House.
Candy House.
Is it on the market right now?
It is. It just got updated before the stream.
I mean, we all call it Candy House, but really it's the deserted cottage.
The deserted cottage?
Yes.
Perfect. So what you can see here are all the different things that you can actually craft with this house. So other than it being an awesome looking house, you can craft a bunch of cookie decor for your house. Some of it you can interact with, like these right here. Oh, no, picking them up. Oops, sorry. Pudding chairs! And then this one up here, you can light as well. It's a little lamp. And now, so of course, the follow-up question is, how do I craft those things? You get a giant chocolate fountain on the side of your house.
How do you not have ants?
Huh?
So many ants.
Clowny's here to help with that.
This house has so many questions.
So you can craft your cookie housing furnitures right here on the chocolate fountain, and you'll see that they require a thing called marvelous chocolate. Now, how do you get marvelous chocolate? So every now and then you have a chance that your fountain explodes and you get a puddle of chocolate there. You can pick up the chocolate there and those give you a marvelous chocolate for 50 labor. And then if you have enough marvelous chocolates, you can go over to the fountain and craft whichever item you'd like to craft for your house. The end. Finn.
All right, well, that's a good description. You have a lot of those there. I guess Clowny keeps the ants away. That's what... Okay.
Yeah.
It's whatever's going
Candy
on
Town.
Over there. I mean, he changed.
Yeah, he's ready to get married now. Come here, baby.
Oh my.
Such a gentleman.
This is like the most uncomfortable.
I'm not a fan.
This is all I have to say about the house.
Wow. I just caught up.
A match made in White Arden,
yes.
I guess.
Clowny is the best.
Okay, next topic. Moving on. What do we got? Not this. We've had enough of this.
Enough of this. I think we're actually up to questions at this point.
But I mean, like, is it a tradable?
Oh, yes. I didn't say yes. Okay. The furniture is... Oh, it died. Sad.
Yes, victory. Oh, thank you very much.
I fixed it.
Thank you.
There you go.
So mean.
Bonus points.
So yes, the furniture is tradable. Good thing you brought that up.
Yeah.
Yay, Ari fixed it. Yay.
So you can use it in any house.
So you can trade all those decoration items. So even if you don't have a house, you might be lucky and someone might sell you one of those things.
Where's the achievement for killing Clowny?
I don't know.
No achievement.
Oh, here's a good question. What's the minimum level for this event?
Ooh.
For the White Arden Ghost Wedding.
I actually do not know. I did not look at that, but I can certainly look at that after. and make sure that information gets out there. Usually we see limits being applied, either you have to be level 30 or 50. I assume, no, for festival it's 30 usually. Mm-hmm. So I would assume it's level 30, but I am not sure, I honestly don't know. Quilladon, do you know?
If Quill's still in chat and watching, hopefully he does.
Or maybe he just heard, like from his desk, he heard
you did shout.
He's not saying level 10. Nope.
Nope.
Yeah, I don't know. I honestly don't know, but I can definitely look at that.
All right, so I think we have some questions to go over.
We do. So we do questions. I'm gonna pull the patch notes while we do this, just to confirm. I think it actually is 10. So the first question while we talk is, when will Aranor Eternal hit the PTS servers? Because I think people are super excited about it.
Very good question. So I mentioned in a previous stream that Aranor Eternal, that is the 3.5 update for NA and EU, is targeting early summer. That's the most detail I've given about it so far. Now, you guys who are veterans will know that typically our updates are on PTS. Prior to that, anywhere between 10 days and, usually about 10 days for larger updates. So I don't know if that helps you out that much, but we are getting a lot closer. I think we're under the 2-month mark now. So it's exciting. I think we're going to be ready to talk more about Aranor Eternal probably the second week of May.
Awesome. I am so excited for that too, because there's like a lot of cool stuff in that. A lot of cool stuff, which I think a lot of our community has been looking at already so far, thanks to the Korea files. This isn't really a question. By the way, it's level 10 for the festival. I just checked it. It's level 10.
Thanks for that.
The question is, please give Ghost Yada mount. That's all.
Who asked that question?
I know who did. I wanted to.
There are only so many people who can actually ask that question.
Is it Molly?
I actually don't think it is.
Okay, that
is
that sounds like a Molly question. Anyway, Ghost Yada, I've not seen any concept for a Ghost Yada, but that sounds like a really cool idea. What do you guys think, chat? Ghost Yada, thumbs up, thumbs down?
I think everything should come in Ghost.
What do you guys think? Everything
should be available.
Like every
in
model
ghost.
In the game should have Ghost version.
We kind of have this collection of Ghost stuff that's been doubled now with all of these new instruments and the fixtures from the Ghost Wedding. But, we have Solmare, we have Storm Rose, Soul Mule. This awesome outfit.
Ghost
Seabug. Right on.
Ghost Seabug. It was actually Amisha. In a stunning turn of events, it was not Molly asking me a Yada question.
Okay. Looks like chat generally agrees Ghost Yada is a positive thing, so we'll take that to note.
That would be cool. That would be really awesome.
Clowny, get out of the house.
That's so creepy.
He's taking a nap. I don't
like it. Oh, no.
Go home, Clowny.
There's a dead Clowny on my
cookie. Clowny, you're drunk. Go home.
His face is in... He's... Oh, goodness. All right. Will the hot tub come back to the marketplace, or is it available as a prize? The good news is, yes, it's available as a prize. If you're really into home decor and you win the Joyful Home Builder Society contest, the hot tub or the heated pool is actually a prize this time around. So please, please enter if you're interested in stuff like that. Next question. We talked about the Ghost Wedding tokens expiring at the end of the festival. They don't. Can we reduce the global cooldown on single planting now that there are less bots in the game?
That's a good question. Probably not, though. I think that's one of the things that XL feels very strongly about, and there's not been too many changes to single planting throughout Arcage's life. But if we do see something like that come across, we'll communicate it to you guys. For now, I've seen nothing that would indicate that.
All right. Are you ever thinking about doing one credit transfers again in the future?
It's been brought up. If we did do one credit transfers again, it would likely coincide with something involving low population servers and offering players the opportunity to leave, but nothing near term for one credit transfers.
All right. So are there any measures taken against players who artificially push zones to peace by killing alts or AFK players?
I know that in some cases, the players who have done that have been actioned. It's one of those things that generally a GM has to happen upon or witness or interact with. Reports need to be submitted about it. So if you see somebody doing something like that, your best thing to do is report them. Now, it's something that the system just should not work that way. That's my opinion on it. But obviously it does, and people do it, and it's a thing. So we don't encourage it, and if you see somebody doing that, report it. I know players have gotten action for it. For example, there was one instance of somebody using a siege tank to murder a bunch of alts to force Hellswamp into peace, and some actions have been taken there in the past. So.
Yep, I can double that. I've seen it happen too, where people have been, you know, mostly it's Hellswamp and it's people killing other alts in order to get Hellswamp into peace so they can get their trigger up into Halsey. We do take action for that. And also, you people who live in Hellswamp, do it in war. I think we did it in war. Do it in war. You can do it. You can do it. So, next question is that some people have heard that in Aranor, Eternal, and Kirbia, regrades now display their percent chances of success. Are there any thoughts of applying such a system to the Archeum supply crates or the Missigon crates, which I know people have been talking about Missigon recently because it's really hard to get the costume out of that one.
Yeah, I think that's something that we would generally be supportive of. I know that in the past with Archeage, those of you who regrade frequently are familiar with the up arrows and circles and whatever those symbols are supposed to mean. Obviously, three up arrows is better than two up arrows. But now you'll be able to see the percentages in 3.5. If Archeage could display percentages better like that for all things, I mean, we would like it, especially for things like the Archeum crates, because, I mean, now you just have a list of things on the box. And I think you've seen our efforts there, because in blog posts in recent times, we've kind of, like, categorized the rarities of certain items. Obviously, we'd want to show you guys if we can. It's just something that Archeage doesn't do well. But in Aranor Eternal, you will be able to see the exact percent of regrading success and how much your stabilizers influence it, stabilizers being charms.
From chat, would we agree that the Barcode Nation is a bunch of memes? I would agree that the entire Archeage community is a bunch of memes. Have you seen our community? You know, all of this is a very, it's always a big job taking on the Archeage community.
Is that still a thing?
It is now.
You just made it still a thing? Okay.
I just made it a thing again.
Yeah, what's a meme? Mystic Wizard asks. I think you are, man. Scapes, you're a meme, right?
What's a meme? Yeah, Scape knows. So, I heard from a friend of a friend of a friend that there might be a regrade event because he has a cousin that works on Tryon. Are these rumors true?
Because what?
I don't know. I just made something up. People are asking about a regrade event.
Because he has a cousin that works at Tryon.
Every time I hear someone ask, is there going to be a regrade event? I say, why do you think that? And then they say, someone told me in Faction Chat.
That's
you
very
really believe things Faction Chat tells you?
There's like two people who could possibly know. I'm one
right.
of them. And so my answer to that is, if you hope hard enough, maybe.
No, it should be, if you hope hard enough, anything is possible.
Yeah, you guys know our approach with regrade events. They happen suddenly and without warning, and that's just because, you know, bro over there is going to buy pretty much every lucky on the auction house in preparation for that, and it kind of, everybody needs that same advantage, not just people who read a thing first or watch a thing. It's just going to happen in real time, and you guys can interact with it, and it's more fair that way.
Yep. Actually, from chat, I can answer this one fast. Yuruki Gamer says, for the Joyful Homebuilder Society contest, does the property need to be a house or can it be a farm? It can be any property that you own. It could be a treehouse. It could be a farm. If you want to decorate it and you feel as though it fits the theme, then yes, you can absolutely enter it. I think a lot of people were asking, like, what about the land around it? What if I have multiple properties in one shot? Just make sure that if you have multiple properties in one shot, it shows your property, and then afterwards you show us that you own each of those properties in separate screenshots. We did have to clarify, because a lot of people were posting like full libraries of pictures, that we're just looking for one good screenshot of the land that you own. And that's mostly due to time. You know, we love all of the screenshots that you guys do. We love pouring through them. The last time we did this, we actually got, I think it was like 886 separate entries, and we have to look through all of those by hand. So it makes it a lot easier for us if it's just everyone submitting one screenshot.
I know a lot of players out there put a lot of effort into their housing, and sometimes we're on a server tour or doing a town hall, and we just happen upon like a magnificent thing. Sometimes we happen upon ridiculous things that are also magnificent. But it's just great to kind of show those off, and especially if you put a ton of time into building it, and there's a lot of customization there, we want to see it. So do the thing.
Yep. So where are we at now? We're at login tracker rewards. I feel as though the login tracker rewards aren't good enough on legacy servers. Can they be changed for those who have been working hard on in-game content?
You know, login tracker is kind of an interesting thing because there's challenges with providing rewards there that are abusable by alts since it's accessible by anybody who just logs in repeatedly. So that's kind of the limitations, and you guys probably guessed that if you've looked at what the rewards are on the login tracker recently. I think it's also hard to target a specific type of player, like an endgame player, a new player, a home builder, or a trade pack runner, or a PvPer, because everybody wants different stuff. So generally, the login tracker is going to contain stuff that applies to most players, is not grossly abusable by a bunch of alts collecting that stuff. And unfortunately, that lands us in the kind of bland state that we've been in for quite some time. But that's just sort of the logic there.
Yep. See someone asking about the winners for the Labor Madness contest. We're in the final phases of choosing those, I believe, right now.
Yeah, good luck to everybody who logged in during that time period, and I hope you are the lucky winner.
Yep, there was a lot of people logged in, and we're really happy to see it. And you never know, you might be the one who's about to sit on just a ton of labor very soon. Can double honor for open world PvP simply be the new normal?
That would be great. That's
everyone
wonderful.
Loves it.
I love the activity that happens when we do run double everything, specifically in like Diamond Shores and even at world events. It's really great to see everybody out there murdering each other. I think that we can talk about that more when we discuss Aranor Eternal, because there's a large bump in honor rewards across the board, not just from open world PvP. It's kind of a operating condition going forward that honor quests and activities generate more honor, and so that might also be modified. But we'll talk about that when we get closer.
Cool. Will we ever see cross-server arena queues?
I have a lot of feelings about this. It's something that we have requested and lobbied for like 2.5-3 years.
Yep.
It is a thing we very much believe in, and that's a region-specific queue. There's a lot of rumors and talk going on about those sorts of things. We will confirm them for our versions if we ever get something like that. But man, we're very passionate about that and think it's a thing that needs to happen. So that's our take on it.
Yep. From chat, at Trine Worlds, is multiboxing being disabled in the game? That's from Arisidia.
Is multibox being disabled? There's no plans for that right now.
No. All right, back from forums. Will the workbench be added to the marketplace? Will a workplace be added for the marketplace event tab tokens that we removed early last year?
So some of the differences between an event and having a festival gift exchanger or the persistent one that's in Mirage Island, it's based on the promotion that those items are provided for. Now, sometimes in the marketplace, we do have limited time tokens that can be exchanged there, and they're kind of worthless after that happens. Unless we end up running an event like that again, at which point, looking at the way we've done events recently, would probably just use a different token. So the short answer on that is no. I mean, those items were available for that promotion and need to be consumed during that time. But for the most part, with our events, they do have a level of persistence in Mirage Isle after the fact. But that's just not the case for that one.
Okay. I saw it just scroll up and chat in the same kind of vein. You know, people were asking about any further compensation for the downtime issues that people experienced during the release of 3.0. And we were talking about this a while back with the release of maybe a compensation workbench that was being looked into and developed.
Yep, our goal for that is to have it coincide with the 3.5 update.
Yep. So moving on to back to forum questions. Will festivals in the future, I guess people already saw that, this person already saw that the current temporary costumes were not permanent. And they were asking for the future, could festivals have ways to change the temporary costumes or their mounts or their items into permanent versions?
We've had some promotions like that in the past. Like our welcome promotions had the opportunity to turn a temporary costume or a temporary mount into a permanent version. The standard procedure going forward with events has just been provide a thing that's thematically appropriate to the event if we have one that exists, and just have it available to help, you know, celebrate the tone of the event. It's a good suggestion. It really is. I don't have a good reason why it's not like that. So maybe I can get some justification from XL, or at least bring up that point to them.
Yep. From Traxxas, why are Nubia Alliance cards attacking the allied player nations when there's a peace treaty? Alliance system is broken for player nations. We actually know of a bug that has happened to some nations on the main servers, and we are engaging XL on that bug. Basically, it creates a situation where the cannons don't fire, but the guards do. So we are aware of it, and we have, you know, started looking into it.
Yeah.
For the last two questions, they are 3.5 related questions. I think we kind of answered this before, but for anyone who just dropped by as we've been doing this, the last two questions are, what's the expected date for update 3.5, and when will we begin talking more heavily about update 3.5? I have so many questions.
We have so many answers, and we do, and we've been working on 3.5 for the last, I don't know, seems like 3 or 4 months now, and I mentioned that we're targeting early July for the release. Or sorry, early July. That's actually not correct. It's going to be early summer, and it's actually not in July. So now I've narrowed it down completely. Good job, Crowley. But we'll begin talking about it more in depth early in May, and that's kind of the goal. I said second week of May for when we will start celebrating Aranor Eternal and provide more information about them.
Right, there's going to be a big release of information. We can start tackling a lot of these questions, especially as we're getting closer and closer. Actually, you know, I lied. I said that that was the last question. That was not the last question. There is one last question, and that question is ... But where's that /dab at, yo?
/dab.
/dab.
That's a good suggestion. Chat, what do you think? What do you think about /dab? Is that something that we should push XL for?
This is they'll catch up and admit it. I'm certain there's going to be a response to that.
What is an acceptable use case for a /dab?
/dab. Yes, no. More emotes.
No, there's a lot of no's.
X-dab.
Yes.
No.
X-dab,
no.
Dab emotes.
No, push for content. It's lame.
Cancer. Wow.
F the horn.
F the dab.
Slash fail. Everyone's trying to slash dab right now, I bet.
Okay, I got it. No slash dab. That's the general consensus, okay?
All right.
A lot of no's. What about stuff? You guys want some stuff?
I think they want stuff, though.
I already gave away one of whatever this is. I have other things to give away.
X for shitty bard singing.
Let's do X for Drunkle.
X for Drunkle.
He's not even a ghost. Like, what is this guy doing?
He shitty bard, just trying to hang out.
He just showed up and is like, hey, I'm gonna do these.
Didn't get signed yet or anything. It's like, I have to get famous somehow.
I see some X Drunkle. That's encouraging me to give away things.
Woo. Actually, while we're Xing up and everyone's talking about this, we have a very important piece of things to talk about, and that is the Ravenspine Wings. I don't want to forget those. There's quiet.
What?
Sorry, I missed the question. I was...
it's the Ravenspine Wings.
What about
we're going to talk about them. The float on them and the way that they actually move in the air.
Okay, you can ask a specific question and I will give an answer to it.
The exact question is, should they be able to float in the air for a very long period of time?
We've looked through that and it's generally, a stronger version of the gliders and wing versions that we've seen in the past. And that's just kind of the way that they were in Korea. Now, you guys will be familiar that sometimes in our versions, those abilities are modified, but that's not the case for the Ravenspine Wings. So the way that we've seen it on live right now is likely the way it will continue to exist, and that's just part of that glider's ability.
Yep.
I mean, you've seen it in the past with gliders like sloth gliders. Every once in a while, one of them will come across that kind of changes our definition on the way things work. And that's the case for the Raven Wings.
Yep. I see a couple don't nerf wings. There they go. There you guys go.
Okay, that's enough Xing. Let's give stuff away. The first thing on deck is an Orchidna figurine. So I'm going to go ahead and roll that now. Good luck, everybody. The Drunkle is not going to get this. One of you guys are. Congratulations, Prince Voodoo Kindu.
Moody can do.
With underscores and silent consonants. Congratulations on your Arkidna figurine. Next up, we're giving away a Yada neck pillow. This is the cool plush that we've given away on the last couple streams. It's basically for car ride, airplane ride, whatever you do to travel, and this can support your neck while you do that. And it, you'll look fashionable with this Yada head. And
people,
does Kirby want to wear it?
People always ask me about the neck pillow on planes when I'm using it. They're like, what is that?
And you're like, oh, it's a Yada, and Yada, we like ghost Yadas, and
right?
never mind. Okay, rolling now. Night Scream 452. Congratulations, Night Scream 452, on your Yada neck pillow.
It's so cute.
It's super cute. It's
here you go. You can hold it.
Great, a Yada choking me on a flight.
Bye.
Sock just stole that.
That's so cute. Look at that face. So cute.
I should be writing people's names down, I think.
Probably.
That might help.
That would be important, yes.
That's a thing I normally do.
Prince Moody
something. We have it in the history on there.
So cute.
I know, I also see people now asking for /twerk in the chat. Man, this chat has gone weird places.
No dab, but plus twerk? Come on. But,
I mean, she does that side thing that kind of looks like a twerk,
they already
kind of
have it, yeah.
There's a dance move that kind of...
All right, I'm giving away one more whatever this is. Yada on a stick. Oddly enough, it's the same Yada head that's
Yada
also on the neck pillow.
I'll take that too.
What happened to this one's pillow? Don't know.
Doesn't get a pillow.
Stick instead. Rolling for it now.
What about a twerking dab? Wow.
Give me the whatever this is.
Broken Serenity is the winner of the second whatever this is.
You use it to like smack your back with it.
Why?
When it
it's like
hurts.
An Asian old people thing. Feels
a what?
Good.
Okay.
I'm serious.
It's legit.
Like you take it like that and you smack your back with it.
Yep.
I'm not seriously.
Okay.
He doesn't Asian watch enough. K-dramas. He doesn't understand.
I know.
I just don't think it would accomplish much.
It feels nice on your back.
All right, we're going to give away 3 cookie houses. So if you were watching the stream earlier, we had a visitor, clowny, kind of creepy looking dwarf guy.
Kinda. We're clowny.
Does keep the ants away, so maybe you'll invite clowny over too.
I thought we're getting married, clowny. Where are you? I'm waiting at the altar.
All right, here we go. This is for the first cookie house. Oh, a lot more X's.
Yeah, people are hyper.
This is
cookie
popular.
House.
Cookie house is more popular than whatever this is. Give you guys just a couple more moments. So who's going to RP the ghost wedding? It's a burning question I need to know the answer to. If you want to, like, post your RP pictures at the wedding, that would be great.
Actually, while we're waiting for the final X's, we can announce this now. You can actually get Arcade stuff through Twitch now. It was made live as of yesterday, I believe. But it also means the Arcade emotes and Arcade icons have shown up in Twitch crates. So if you guys are collecting the Twitch crates, you can actually get Arcade themed things out of them. So hopefully we're going to get to see some of them. There's some pretty funny ones in there, in addition to the Arcade icons and, you know, great success and stuff like that.
Oh, it's a match made in White Arden. It's so beautiful.
Oh, jeez.
Double.
Oh, it just showed up on my screen. Oh, jeez.
What is it doing?
That's so creeps.
I can't stop looking. The hell is going on?
I thought he was smacking the groom.
Please.
Get out of here.
Okay, first cookie house goes to the Park Side. Congratulations, yes. The Park Side. Number 2 cookie house. This one is specifically in honor of yesterday. We're going to roll that now, if you get my drift. Number 2 goes to Gatito.
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 Congrats.
Ooh, you can't burn down a cookie house, guys. It melts. Then it gets sticky. It's bad.
Yeah, if things were optimal, if the stars aligned correctly, we would have offered the Cookie House yesterday, but had to be today instead.
Had to be today.
Everybody's like, why a Cookie House in April? Doesn't make a lot of sense. It does if you think about it.
It does.
Third Cookie House rolling today. Right now, let's go. Third one goes to HDMXZD. Congratulations to you, a lot of letters, HDMXZD. All right, and those are the things I have to give away today. So congratulations to our winner. Winners, congratulations to everybody who got to see Clowny. That's a good thing. Maybe you can contract him for your next event.
Yes.
I got nothing.
Hire he does contract work. At your parties.
Yeah.
Oh. Birthday parties and sewer meetings.
What?
All right, guys. So thank you, everyone, for coming today. We will be back next week. I won't be back next week. I'm going to be gone. It's going to be you guys, and I'm going to enjoy it. I'll be...
What are you trying to say?
I won't be here.
What statement did you just make?
That you guys will have a great time without me. That's the statement I've made.
I heard no rules.
What? No.
I have a lot of giveaways.
My boss is still here.
Like all giveaways dream.
Okay, well.
I thought no rules was only applied with Amanda not being here.
I don't know. What do you think, Amanda? No rules?
I agree.
There you go.
Geez. All right. Linda.
<That's so> We're going to have like Kirby rolling for prizes.
It's going to be, yeah, I see the chat's really into the no rules thing. But guys, we'll be back next week for another ArcAge live stream. Hope you guys have a great weekend, and we can't wait to talk about 3.5 with you guys real soon, coming up nice and fast. But otherwise, bye everybody.
Yep, thanks for watching, guys. Have a good weekend.
Bye.